Welcome at Whisper Power. Today we are on Motoryacht Independence and we would like to show you the Octopower hybrid energy system on board of this nice boat. Well, if you come on in, then I will show you. Welcome, we are now inside the 16 meter steel Motoryacht Independence. This Motoryacht is specially built for an owner with had some specific requirements on how he wants to use the boat. He wants to navigate the northern part of Europe, even as the south part, at the Mediterranean area, and maybe he has some wishes to go to the Caribbean. Well, he will also go with the boat to areas where we have restricted use of diesel generators on board ships. And of course, nowadays it has been more difficult to run for a long period of time diesel generators, as it's not that social. Of course, he also wants to limit the generator running time to save fuel, and that's also why we use some solar power on board of this boat. Otherwise, he wants to dock in marinas, for example, where he has the availability of sometimes limited shore power connection, and so limited power. And even though he will visit some marinas where the quality of the shore power is not that good, and for example in the end of the marina where the voltage of the shore power connection is really low, and so that means that you do not have a lot of power available to charge the battery system. He wants to stay for a longer period of time year round. So that is also means that we have extensive air conditioning and heating systems on board the ship, and so it's fully full comfort. He also like to go for anchorage for a longer period of time, and so that means that we have to design all the systems to facilitate that. He also have extended use of remote monitoring system on board the boat, so that he can see from a distance the energy system, the heating and the air conditioning system, so he can remotely switch that on and off. He also have some alarm indications on board the boat, and finally at last he also have some cameras on board the ship, so even when he's not on the boat he can have a look what's happening in and outside the boat. Well, let's have a look what kind of systems and components we have on board. We see over here a television system together with a complete entertainment system. We have a fridge for wine, and over here we see the bridge of the boat, where we have all kind of navigation equipment like radar and chart plotter, GPS, autopilot systems. We also have the management system with the screens where we can see all the systems on board the boat. We have an extensive lighting system with LED lights on the roof and over here at the windows. Well, let's have a look at the galley, what kind of equipment we have installed over there. We are in the galley where all kind of equipment is installed. We see over here an air fryer, a coffee maker. On the other side we have a microwave oven. We have a four-hub cooking station. We have a water cooker. We have a fridge and a freezer. And on this side, we also have a dishwasher, which is running at the moment. Of course, we also have a sink, and the sink is connected to the gray and the black water system, where we all have all kind of pumps in the boat, also for the showers. And in the front cabin we also have a washing machine. Beside that we of course also have the lightning on 12 and 24 volt, and also 230 volt lighting. And as said before, we also have the air conditioning and the heating system, which will also heat up the boat completely. So all the comfort from home we have on board of this boat. We have seen what kind of equipment is installed in the boat and the wishes of the owner. That we will translate that to a load balance. In the load balance we see a list of all the equipment with their power ratings, the quantity and the hours it should be used on board the boat. Beside of that, we also want to know where the energy needs to come from. Is it from the battery or is it from the inverter or the shore power? In such a case, we can make the calculations and the math, and we can decide what kind of capacity your battery should be, what kind of inverter power rating you require, what kind of battery charger system you need, and what kind of generator capacity you require on board the boat, so that we can completely design it to your requirements. So that's really crucial to always make the load balance for the system. We are now on the backside of the boat where we have the shore power inlet and the shore power cable. We can plug in 230 volt, 50 or 60 cycles, or even 120 volt, 50, 60 cycles with a maximum of 16 amps, so we can plug in worldwide. We open off the entry, we take off the protective cover of the plug, we plug in the shore power, we tighten the ring, and we have made the connection to the shore power. So we are now inside the technical room, which is underneath the aft deck and next to the engine room. We were just outside looking at the shore power connection. Well, the shore power connection is connected to the Whisper Power galvanic isolator, also called isolation transformer, which separates galvanically the boat AC system with the shore AC system, and thereby preventing corrosion of the hull and makes the system on board safe again, so that we can safeguard it with a earth leakage switch. Well, from this isolation transformer we go into the supercharger, in this case a 24 150 amp charger, which in this case has a dual input, so this can be fed by a generator with permanent magnet or with shore power, and so it can handle both. In this case, the 24 150 supercharger will charge the battery set on board the boat. Well, this boat has a 24 volt system with 1500 amp hours battery capacity, and that's built of gel 2 volt power blocks, similar as this one. This is a little bit smaller one, but in this boat the battery set is in front underneath the kitchen. Another option which is available today is to go for long life lithium ion batteries, which are much smaller, so more compact and less weight, so about 30%, which makes it possible to have in small cabinets and small rooms to fit high capacity batteries. Well, from the battery set we go to the DC distribution to the super inverter. In this case, that is connected to the battery set with four entries to make it all connectable. It has 14 kVA power rating with a maximum power of 28 kVA. It's all single phase, and that's feeding the whole ship. So all the electrical cooking, all the air conditioning, all the appliances are running on single phase on the inverter side of the ship. From that side, we discharge the batteries. Then if we need more power and we need to charge up, if we are not connected to shore power, then we can run the Genverter system, which is a permanent magnet generator set, which supply on three-phase input two of the superchargers. And so we can charge up to 6.5-7 kilowatt on charging the power set. Having said that, that's the generator where we're normally running on. In this particular boat, we also have a 25 kilowatt fixed speed 1500 RPM for backup. And this backup is to supply really fast electricity 230 volt to the three superchargers, so we can have up to 450 amp charge current into the batteries, so we can really do fast charge. Another possibility we have used on this particular boat is we have a power takeoff connected to the back end of the generator, which supplies a hydraulic pump, and the hydraulic pump is connected to the zero stabilization system which is on board this boat. So even in the case we are on anchorage, we can switch on the stabilization system, which will be fed by the 25 kilowatt generator. Well, beside of all these systems, we also have connected the diesel generators, of course, with water locks, inlet filters, water exhaust separating systems. That's all installed here. So this is how the system looks like. And now we are going inside and have a look at the diagram, how the complete system is built up. From the load balance and the owner's wishes, we came to a complete design of the system, which looks like I have here on the screen. Well, we start with the main battery bank, which is a 24 volt, 40 kilowatt hour battery set, which is composed of 2 volt GL traction batteries. These are connected to a DC bus bar system, and onto that we have connected the super inverter of Whisper Power. This super inverter supplies 14 kVA of power with a startup capability of 28 kVA, which gives you clean and silent, powerful energy to the onboard anchor phase system. After you have discharged the batteries, you need to recharge the batteries. And in this case, we have 5 possibilities to charge the batteries. The first possibility is to connect to shore power, where we have the shore power cable, the shore power inlet, 16 amps maximum, 120 volt or 230 volt is worldwide pluggable, 50 or 60 cycles, doesn't matter. This will go into the system and goes into the first supercharger, which gives you a charge capability of 150 amps. The second possibility is that this supercharger is connected to the permanent Whisper Power Genverter system, which then can also fast charge the batteries completely up to 100% in a safe way. The third option is that we have a onboard main engines. We have a 150 amp 24 volt alternator with a 3-step charge process, so for a safe, fast, reliable charge up to 100% capacity. The fourth option we have on board is the Whisper Power solar modules, 185 watt peak each, 2 pieces, which is connected to the Whisper Power SunTrack solar charge regulator, which has MPPT functionality, and that's connected to the batteries as well. Then the last possibility we have on this boat, we also have a backup 25 1500 RPM Whisper Power generator set, which makes 230 volt out. That's coming into the AC distribution system, and that's connected to 3 superchargers, which give you the possibility to fast charge the battery set with 450 amps. Additionally, the generator is fitted with a power takeoff, and the power takeoff is connected to a hydraulic pump, and the hydraulic pump is feeding the zero speed stabilization system, which is on board the boat. This makes it possible to stabilize the boat even on the anchorage. And so then we start up the generator. Well, all these components are interconnected via a CAN bus, Whisper Power CAN bus system, which is finally connected to the 10 inch touchscreen panel. And in this case, on board, this panel is also connected to the glass bridge system, for example, a Simrad or a Garmin system, where we have all the functionalities to measure and to control the electronics on board, but also to run and control the air conditioning and the heating system. Well, via a router, this is connected to the internet, so we have the possibility to remotely control and monitor the system with a smartphone or with your laptop. That's all possible. Near the batteries, we also have the battery shunt, where we do the measurements so that we can easily see on the screen the status of the battery and if we have to recharge the batteries, yes or no. Also, we have included a automatic start-stop system. So if the batteries are running low, we can automatically start and stop the generator to fast charge the batteries up to a certain level. We are now on the roof of the deck house. On the roof of the deck house, we will find two solar modules, which are 185 watt peak whisper power panels. The whisper power panel is an all black model, which is connected to the SunTrack solar charge regulator. The solar charge regulator in this case has a MPPT functionality, which means maximum power point tracking. And that ensures that we always get the most energy out of the solar module where we can charge the batteries with. The SunTrack charge regulator is connected via the CAN bus system to the 10-inch touchscreen panel, which is mounted on the bridge. That touchscreen panel is connected via Wi-Fi, where we will find here the antenna, the Wi-Fi antenna, where the connection is made. The other side of the Wi-Fi is a router, and that router connects to the 4G system, where we have the other antenna. So we make a connection to the internet. In that case, we can assure you that you always have the possibility to remotely operate and control your system. So you can see the status of your energy system, including the solar production, but you can also control and check your air conditioning and heating system on board, as well as alarms and eventually systems for the camera system. Well, that's everything which is mounted on the roof of the deck house. We are now at the helm, where we find all the navigation and communication equipment, and we also will find the Whisper Power 10-inch screen touch display. Here we can find all the vital functions of the ship: the energy, the solar, the generator, the air conditioning and the heating systems. Even the wiper system is integrated in the system. This system is connected via the CAN bus to the glass bridge system, like supplied by Simrad and Garmin. We have an identical screen, so it's an exact copy. So I want to show you more in detail on the large screen the functions we have. We see the energy. Here we find the supercharger number one, which is now connected to the shore power, which is pretty limited. And we have set the current limit to 9 amps to prevent the shore power to collapse. And we see that we have roughly about a little bit over 55 amps of charge current. We see that the generator with the permanent magnet is not running at the moment, which is connected to the supercharger as well. The onboard appliances are all connected to the super inverter, which is in this case a 14 kVA. Which has clean and silent and really stable sine wave output, so that even the most sensitive equipment on board is running smoothly. Then we see here the overview of the generator, where we can start and stop the generator. We can see the runtime, and we can also see when we need to do the next service. Over here we see the Whisper Power Smart Shunt, where we can measure the battery capacity of the onboard battery system. In this case, we see that the
batteries are discharged and we see the state of charge is about 62%. Later on, I will show you the start and stop function of the generator. Here we see the Whisper Power SunTrack, which is the solar system on the roof of the deck house, where we can see that the battery voltage is 25 volt and that we are charging the batteries at the moment. And we see that we have roughly harvest about 400 kilowatt hours in the total lifetime of the system. The next one is the generator start and stop functionality. In this case, you see there is also a possibility to auto start the generator on low battery capacity. So when it's really needed to charge the battery backup, then the generator will automatically start and stop. Here we have an overview of the air conditioning system, the wiper system, and we can see the heating system, and we can see the temperatures in the deck house and the engine room. Well, if we go back to the generator, we also can do it here because then we have all the controls together. Then we start the generator. We see that the generator is glowing at the moment, so it will start in a short period of time. Now the generator has been started. I can hardly hear it. I know that the generator is on, so I can hear it a little bit, but it's really low noise. We see here that the supercharger is now fed by the generator system, and we see now that the charge current has been going up to 147 amps. And we see over here that we are charging the battery with 103 amps. So the rest, the difference, is going into the ship system and is consumed partly by the inverter and partly by the lighting and other equipment which is running at the moment. Well, this is all the functionality we see on the large screen. We have that on the 10-inch screen as well. We are still at the screen. We are now going to do a measurement of the sound levels in the deck house. We see that the standard level is about 30 dBA. Now we start the generator and then we measure what the noise level will be. We see the generator is running at the moment and it's now going to more load on the supercharger. We see that's now roughly 147 amps charging. The noise level is about 36-37 dBA, so you see that it's really quiet. Now we are going to the galley and do the same measurement to see what the noise level will be at the galley. We are in the galley area and we want to do the noise level test again to see what the noise level will be in this area. We see a fluctuation between 37 and 40 dBA, which is really a silent for this area. We also have a Whisper Power 25 kilowatt diesel generator on board, which has 1500 RPM. We will start the generator and see what the noise level will be. Standard is about 37. The generator is running and the dBA is about 55. Well, in the case when you're going to the boat, you can first check with your app what the status of your system on board is. Here we have the Whisper Power app. You can see the energy setup,
where we can see that the battery is being charged, 65% full. And so that's power enough. I want to switch on the air conditioning. So when I come on board, I have to switch the air conditioning on, and so it's nice and cool when I arrive at the boat.